Now, breast augmentation, should you have your implant put under the muscle or above the muscle? That is a very common question. Probably what I mainly do is under muscle or dual plane, and I'll explain what dual plane is in a moment. There's lots and lots of different reasons for putting above or below the muscle. So it depends on what result you want from your breast augmentation. And it also depends on what sort of breast you have to start with. A lot of patients that I see are post-pregnancy or post-weight, and they do have a lot of emptiness, and there's very thin layer above, like, our breast tissue. So that means that if we put the implant above the muscle, then you're going to see the implant, and that's not an attractive look. So that's probably the main reasons. Generally, I find that above the muscle gives you a more natural result for a number of reasons, and I'll go through that. However, majority of patients that I see that want breast augmentation don't have much coverage. So it's all about how much of your own breast tissue you have to cover the implant that determines if we can get away with doing it above the muscle. Or we have to put under the muscle. Now, the reason for putting under the muscle is to get extra padding on the implant so that you don't get a visible implant. Now, the other reason that some surgeons talk about is there is some evidence that capsular contracture, or the hardness that happens around the implants, is a little bit reduced if you put it under the muscle. So if you have 3 centimeters, so if you pinch your breast and you have 3 centimeters of tissue, then we should be able to do it above the muscle. Now, the reason why above the muscle is usually a better cosmetic result is because when you put it under the muscle, you're going to see the muscle contracting. So you're going to have the implant, and then you're going to have the muscle on top of the implant, and every time the muscle contracts, it pushes the implant, so you get these muscle bands. So when you're sort of doing pec exercises, you move your hands, the muscle's contracting onto the implant, and you can actually see the muscle contracting and the implant underneath. Now, we don't tend to the implant doesn't get covered with the muscle completely, which means that you're going to have some implant underneath the muscle. So if you have the muscle here, implant here, some of the implant will sit under the muscle. So when this contracts, this will come out, and you'll get this sort of appearance of the implant just getting pushed out underneath when you contract your muscle. So that's the reason why generally you get a better cosmetic result above the muscle. However, saying that, majority of women that I see do have not enough coverage of the breast tissue. So for example, if you're an A cup, then we do a breast augmentation, doesn't matter if it's teardrop or round, above the muscle, you're going to see the edge of the implant. It's going to be like a bit of a fake look, because you're going to see really the outline of the implant. It's going to be very obvious that you had an implant. So that's why really a lot of the time, even though cosmetically you probably if you had enough coverage, you would go above. Now, then there's a dual plane. So one of the biggest issues in breast augmentation surgery is called the double fold, and I'll have some examples. I'll put some examples up later of that. Double fold is your own fold that doesn't stretch out over the implant. So when you do breast augmentation, that's probably one of the bugbears. It's very can be sometimes hard to predict. So a double fold usually doesn't happen if you put it the breast implant above the muscle, because the skin gets stretched out. If you put it under the muscle, a good way of doing it is to do what's called a dual plane. It's when you create a plane above the muscle and under the muscle to release the skin from the underlying tissue so that you can get a rounding out of the lower pole of the breast to get a better result. So those are the sort of steps that I go through with you in the consultation. Those are the three options. So we got above the muscle, dual plane, or under the muscle. So then obviously teardrop versus round as well, but that's a completely different discussion. So hopefully that explains the reasoning. As I say, if you have enough coverage of breast tissue, then above the muscle is a really good option. And one more thing that is really important to keep in mind. Also, the breast implants, when we put it under the muscle, the muscle is attached to the sternum. So it means we can't really push the implants in and give as good of a cleavage as we would want to sometimes, because the muscles obviously attach to just the outside of the sternum and it doesn't allow the implant to come in. The other thing that happens is that the muscle pushes the implant to the side, so you have more risk of the implant moving to the side when you do it under the muscle. If you do it above the muscle, you can put the implant a little bit closer to cleavage, so you can get a little bit better cleavage. So cosmetic is much better. You don't have that tension on the implant that pushes the implant to the side. So those are things that are a consideration as well.